Format is an easy and a great way to set up an online graphic design portfolio. And today I'm going to walk you through step by step on how to use Format to make your very own portfolio website with ease. But first, let's take a quick look at some existing websites that customers of Format have made themselves. Now, Format is a web builder made by creatives for creatives. And here is a designer that has utilized Format for their website. So as you can see, the site looks clean and pretty awesome, displaying this designer's work with a neat interface. There is a menu bar at the top, and this designer has their work orientated in a drop-down menu in different categories. Now, a really cool function is that when you select one of the projects to view it, you can then view all of the projects in a toggle kind of slider menu. But let's jump into how to exactly use Format for your very important portfolio website. And if you click the link in the description box below, you have a 2-week free trial and then a 25% discount thereafter on the upgraded version. It does help to have an online portfolio away from social media, as it does look more professional, and Format is fairly easy to use and also to set up in a quick amount of time. So after signing up, the first thing that we need to do is to select a theme for our website, as you can see here. There are actually quite a nice amount of themes provided by Format, and they all look pretty awesome. And also you can actually preview the mobile versions too. But once you've selected a theme from the available choices, you can then see the progress of your website creation in the dashboard here. We can now go ahead and begin to customize the actual design of our website in the Format Web Builder. So here is my template layout ready to be customized. And on the left hand side, you will notice a toolbar. So here are such things like the ability to change your theme, customizing the color and the typography on your website, and even a code editor too. And on the far left, you have the pages section, the dashboard, which you've just come from, and also a means to set up a shop and a blog on your website. We're going to be taking a look at these things a little bit later. Let's quickly take a look at the typography on my website. So I can choose the font and the size for specific areas on my website, and there is a nice amount of fonts to choose from. So as you can see, there are header text options, body text options, and also base font choices. To actually add your work in a portfolio page, you can head into the galleries page here in the pages menu. But first, we're asked to add a sample page, which essentially just makes life easier for us, because it's a kind of a template for the page layout. Now you're able to upload your work and your images from your computer or Dropbox. And this is actually the header for my gallery page, as of now anyway. And don't forget to save your changes as you go. But Format does actually remind you from time to time to save your changes, which really does help. So let's head back into the dashboard real quick to track our progress. The fifth step is to edit the contact page, and Format tells us how important a contact page is. Because as a graphic designer working online, we really do need a kind of contact between customers and potential clients. So as of now, we have a very bland and a basic contact page with a contact form below. But like we did earlier for the galleries page, we can add a template on this page too. Again, Format provides us with a decent amount of choices for the contact page, so choose one of them and then add it to your website. We've got placeholder images and sections, and all we need to do is to click and edit the imagery and the text. It's just that simple. I'm now on my About page and editing the header image. You can zoom in and out like so, and also rearrange the image around like I'm doing here. If you want to make your pages more detailed and intricate, you can add a new section below. We can add text, images, forms, and even videos. And I think it'd be really neat to have a video embedded onto my About page. All I need to do is type in the URL, and then bingo, I've added a video on my About page with ease. So here I'm in the pages menu, and you can see that I've got 3 pages on my website currently. But let's head into my galleries page and edit the logo header, because I feel the Tom text is too bland and boring. If you click the logo here, we can change it like so. We have two choices open to us, either using a text logo or an actual image logo that we upload from our computer. So once uploaded, you can adjust its size like I'm doing here. And in the menu below, we can even change the icon of our website that's going to be shown in the toolbar search of a browser. Also here, we can check the view of the website on both mobile and desktop, which is always handy to do whilst you're working through your website. Now I've got a couple more neat things to show you in today's video. And that is firstly, if you want to add a new page, you can do that here. You actually have quite a lot of options open to you in adding content and pages on formats. So I could add a page dedicated to my YouTube videos as an example. And like before, we can use a template of placeholder content, or we can do it from scratch, which gives us more control. So lastly, here on the left that I mentioned earlier, we have the option to add a store and even to add a blog on our website. But let's take a quick look at the store option. You can then give a name to your store, and format's going to integrate it into your website in a matter of seconds. Then you can simply connect your PayPal account to format and thus your store. From here, it's just a case of adding in your products, the descriptions, the imagery, and then start selling. This is a neat function that every design portfolio can make use of. Heading back into the dashboard, we can see the last point on the list is to connect to the experts of format. This is where you can ask questions and source some help too. So finally, let's take a look at my homepage. Now I've got the toolbar in the top right corner, as well as my social media icons and the links up there too. I've gone for a chic minimal black layout for my website. And as I scroll down, you can see that I've embedded a YouTube video trailer on my website's homepage. Now this is cool because people can play it right away, but also they can click the YouTube logo and be directed to my YouTube channel. So as you can see, there's a banner at the top. And as I scroll downwards, it slowly fades into the background, and I think this is a really neat looking effect. My work is displayed below, and people can click onto the image they want to view, and then are going to be taken for a closer look. Scrolling through your work is really easy too. So there is today's video on how you can design an awesome portfolio website with format with ease. Check the links in the description box below for a 2-week free trial and also a 25% discount thereafter. Have a great day, everybody, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.